Very warm greetings, friends, from Cape Town. The whole world stands faced with a common threat of climate change. This global threat already affects us all, in particular the poorest and the most vulnerable. That alone should move all governments to act. But my heart is heavy when I imagine the devastation that will face our children and our children's children if we do not act now to stop it. The final measure of a generation's courage is the memory of what they have done. We must live in memory as the generation that pulled humanity back from the brink of catastrophic climate change. Droughts, floods, and water shortages are already on the increase because of climate change. Science has spoken on the urgent need to tackle the challenge. Now it is time to listen to our consciences. There is a clear moral imperative to tackle the causes of global warming. We're part of nature, yet we alone can act. Our destiny must be as guardians of the earth, not users and abusers of the only home we have. We all have a responsibility to learn how to live and develop sustainably in a world of finite resources. We must make peace with this planet. We're all in this together. Therefore, we must act as global citizens, not as isolated individuals. Governments in Copenhagen must fight for an agreement that will speedily reduce the emissions that cause the problem and provide rapid assistance to those who will suffer most. In South Africa, we showed that if we act according to justice, we can turn tides. Worldwide, we have a chance to start turning the tide of climate change, but only if all governments commit themselves to a fair, binding, and sustainable climate agreement in Copenhagen. Let us kindle the hope that together we can act to ensure a safe climate future for ourselves, our children, all the creatures with whom we share God's earth. God bless you.